Welcome to Cursorless. This is the first in a series of tutorial videos designed to get you slicing and dicing code fast. This video assumes that you've already installed Cursorless. If not, check the description for a link. It should be a breeze. This video also assumes that you're familiar with the Talon alphabet, which is a way to map from words to letters. So for example, we say air for A, bat for B, etc. If you're not familiar with that, there's tons of great resources online. I've dropped a couple in the description below, or with Talon listening, you can just say help alphabet. Let's see that. Help alphabet. Drowse. So the next thing you'll notice probably there was that I made a popping noise to wake Talon up, and I said drowse to put Talon to sleep. So you can safely ignore both the popping noise and drowse if you hear them. It's just a way for me to quickly switch back and forth between talking to you and talking to Talon. Note that those commands are not standard, so you won't have those in them in a vanilla Talon installation. On this channel, those are the only commands that I'll try to use that are not standard. If you want to see videos of me jamming with my fully custom setup, check out my personal YouTube channel. The first command I'll show you today is cursorless docs drowse. Now that command just takes you to our documentation hub where you can learn more about cursorless. Tab close, focus code, drowse. The next command is our cheat sheet. Cursorless cheat sheet, drowse. Just a quick reference so you can see what's out there. And then the docs and the videos are a way to actually learn how to use all these things. With the boring stuff out of the way, let's actually do some proper cursorless commands. The first thing you'll notice is these little hats that are over various letters in cursorless. The important thing is which letter the hat is over. That's how you're gonna refer to the token. So for example, if I want to refer to the token and, we can see that it has a hat over the N, so I need to use near to refer to it. Take near, drowse. So that was our first cursorless command, take near. So every cursorless command has an action and a target. So in this case, the action was take, which means select, and the target was near. So the token with the hat over the end. Now, if that hat is not gray, then we need to use the color in addition to the letter. Take blue urge, drowse. That's single tokens. Now let's say we want to refer to something bigger. We can use past to create a range between two targets. Take odd past each. Drowse. Somewhat ironically, as you can see, cursorless is actually great at moving your cursor around, and in fact, even at adding multiple cursors. Take urge and fine. Drowse. But let's do some properly cursorless actions. So if I want to delete the word dice, I can just say chuck drum. Drowse, and you can see it deletes that token without ever moving my cursor. Now, so far we've been doing everything in terms of tokens, which is useful, but they're not the only way to look at a document. Let's work with lines. Chuck line near. Drowse. If I just say line, then that refers to the line or lines containing my cursor or cursors. Take line. Drowse. Now you can select and you can delete. Let's give you a few more actions to play with. You can use the action pre to move your cursor before a target, as in pre-urge. Drowse. Post, similarly, will move your cursor after a target, like post-air. Drowse. Another useful action is change, which will delete a target and then leave your cursor where the target used to be so that you can insert something new there. Change harp. Drowse. One of the great things about Talon is that it allows you to chain commands together so that you can code much faster. Change look word using. Drowse. And that's part one of the tutorial. I'll quickly remind you before I go, cursorless docs to pop up the documentation and cursorless cheat sheet to show the cheat sheet. Next time, let's write some code. Thanks for watching. Record stop.